Hi, I'm Jake. It's August 9th, and I'm out here in the middle of the hill on our stone vineyard. On both sides of me, we have Cabernet. Down here to the east is Mockama Creek. You can't see that. Kind of on a little flat plateau on the top of this hill. It disappears down the other side and ends at Mockama Creek, and that's where we have our Chardonnay growing down there. And over here is a ridge of hills, on the other side of which is Healdsburg, and at the base of those hills is the Russian River. The Chardonnay vineyard wraps around here at the bottom, following those waterways, and the Cabernet grows here, and then up behind me, higher up the hill also. And this vineyard is kind of a temperamental genius of a Cabernet vineyard. Where we're standing right now, you can see that the vines are really small and straggly, and this represents a really small part of the vineyard. My friend Juan used to call this a lunar, which means a half moon, because it's like a crescent shape right at the top of this hill where there's barely any topsoil at all, and we can't really get things to grow very much no matter what we do. You can see that we've added emitters here in the hope that we'll get the vines a little bit more water and a little bit more nutrients, but still things are really small and scraggly. But that's kind of representative
You're taking a video of him.
That's kind of representative of the way, come here, sweetheart, of the way this vineyard is generally. You know, the topsoil here is something like a foot thick in some places. Some places there isn't any at all.
Be careful.
And then below that.
Oh my God, right there.
And then below that is the bedrock of Chalk Hill Road, which is compressed volcanic ash. And I wanted to show you something. This isn't that interestingly enough, right? And here we are down here, and you can see that the vines are bigger, there's more fruit on them, everything is just fuller and more vigorous, and we're right in the slope of a hill. And generally speaking, you'd expect the stuff that's on the flat to be more vigorous than the stuff that's down on the hill. But over the years, all the topsoil, and I mean over the thousands of years, all the topsoil on the top of that hill has just come down off the side. We don't even cultivate. We haven't cultivated this field in 30 years, and yet there's just barely any topsoil up there at all. I just wanted to point out this thing right here, and it's not very, again, visually it's not very interesting, and it's not really a super significant part of what we do, but it's a probe, and it goes 40 inches into the ground, and what it does is it reads soil moisture, and it reads it continuously, second to second, and then we download that information. Has a chip in it. We download that information out of this probe into a computer program, and then we can look at the soil moisture on a graph. You know, what was the soil moisture at noon? What was it at midnight? What was it on Tuesday? And then what was it Thursday? So then when we irrigate, we can look at what happens too. And the probe shows things at different depths. It shows what the soil moisture is at 4 inches and at 8 inches and at 24 inches and at 32 and at 40. Like that. And one of the things that you'll see on this vineyard is that the irrigation has an effect down to about 12 inches, and then after that nothing happens at all and nothing changes because the water can't even get into the bedrock at all. So the vines are growing into a place where there's no water accessible, there's no water accessible to them at all below about 12 inches. And that's a really interesting problem to deal with from point of view of farming. The guy who does the consulting for us does this for a lot of people, and he's a PhD, and I think he still has a really hard time wrapping his brain around how quickly this vineyard dries out just because there's no water holding capacity because there's hardly any soil. Anyway, all those things, including the slightly difficult climate, are all things that add up to a wine that just has a lot of intensity and a lot of complexity and a lot of tannic structure. And there's nothing I like better than farming single vineyard wines and making single vineyard wines, because when I drink them, those are the things that I think about, all these things that make them what they are. And I think that's what makes them fascinating. Good or bad, they're such a great representation of place.